Now let us see the exemption in respect of capital gains arising on transfer of agricultural land. And this exemption is dealt with in section 54B. Now deduction under section 54B is available only to an individual. Okay, the capital asset which is transferred should be an agricultural land. Okay, now when we say agricultural land, the agricultural land for which the exemption under this section is available should be a land which has been used for 2 years by the assessee or his parents for agricultural purposes. If the land is not used for agricultural purposes during this period, then this exemption is not available. Okay, so let's say you have been using an agricultural land for agricultural purposes. There is a capital gain which arises to you. Then the gains which have arisen or the amount that you have realized should be invested. The capital asset to be purchased should be an agricultural land. Okay, so you sell one agricultural land which you were using for agricultural purposes and you purchase another agricultural land, right? When you do this thing, the amount of deduction or the quantum of reduction available to you is either the amount of capital gains, okay, or the cost of the new asset, whichever is less. We just discussed this in the context of section 54 earlier, so you can go and check the detailed explanation there as to how do you compare these two vis-a-vis the sale consideration. Right? And this new agricultural land that we just spoke about has to be purchased within 2 years from the date of transfer. Right? So if you don't purchase this asset within 2 years from the date of transfer, then the exemption that you have claimed earlier in respect of capital gains arising on the agricultural land will become taxable again. Right? And of course, the second thing which you need to keep in mind is these two points, which is that let's say, for example, you transfer an agricultural land which is exempt from capital gains tax, okay, and you want to buy another agricultural land, but you are not able to purchase this before the due date of filing of return of income, right? So what is the position that you will take in the return? So in the interim, what the law provides is you can invest that amount in the capital gains amount scheme on or before the due date of furnishing of return of income. Okay, same as what we discussed in the context of section 54 above. And similarly, another condition is that when you purchase this agricultural land, you cannot transfer it within 3 years, okay, from the date when you purchase it. The term construction will not apply in context of agricultural land. Okay, so basically, if new asset is sold, new asset is what? The new agricultural land that you purchased within 3 years from the date of purchase, then whatever capital gains arose to you earlier, which were exempted, will be reduced from the cost of this particular agricultural land. And accordingly, you pay a higher amount of capital gain on this land, right? Which will always be a short-term capital gain.